This liquid biopsy abstract builds on some prior work that we've done with liquid biopsies. And you know, where liquid biopsies in colorectal cancer have really been shown to be most useful there for, or thus far, has really been in the adjuvant setting. And so in adjuvant colorectal cancer, what we've shown is that the use of ctDNA to predict recurrence is quite high, and that initially came from work out of GNET in the Australian group in stage 2 colon cancer. So what we did is we took a group of patients, around 70 patients, and we looked at their ctDNA after definitive therapy. And definitive therapy could be surgery, it could be patients that had adjuvant chemotherapy, as well as some patients that actually had neoadjuvant therapy too and then went on to surgery. And what we showed at what ASCO was that there was a positive predictive value of 100% in terms of predicting recurrence if you could actually detect ctDNA. And this was using Guardant Health's LUNAR assay. And LUNAR assay is unique in so far as prior ctDNA assays have just looked at genomic profiling and tumor-only profiling. But what Guardant does is they integrate this tumor-only genomic profiling with methylation as well. And what we showed at ASCO was that methylation increases the sensitivity of detecting ctDNA at these time points. And so we took it a step further. It took the same group of patients, but focused on the patients that actually only had neoadjuvant therapy. Some, again, who received adjuvant, but around 43 patients who received neoadjuvant therapy. And we wanted to see if we could actually monitor treatment response with ctDNA. So previously we just looked at recurrence, and now we're actually looking at response. And similarly to what we showed previously is that epigenetics helps the sensitivity at these various time points. And epigenomic calls at the end of neoadjuvant therapy, at the end of surgery, as well as at the end of adjuvant therapy can increase your sensitivity of detecting ctDNA at those time points. And what was striking is if you look at patients who were what we call ctDNA persistent, that means patients that never cleared. Patients that were ctDNA clear, that means patients that initially had ctDNA detectable and then their definitive therapy cleared that ctDNA. And then patients that were ctDNA negative, in terms of their recurrence, the curves separate quite widely. So the patients were negative, many at nearly 500 days of follow-up have not yet recurred. The patients who cleared, there were people that recurred later on, but their time to recurrence was on the order of 300-ish days. Whereas if you were persistent and you never cleared with your definitive therapy, your time to recurrence is quite high. So what we showed was not only that ctDNA can be a marker of response to these various therapies, but also that the kinetics of clearance or not clearing can actually be indicative of your time to recurrence later on.